vote against or a list of action. You have plenty of actions proposed, and let's have a look on what the members prioritize. Everybody had some kind of possibility to vote with green dots and red dots for or against actions. For the strategic direction, innovative scholarly communication, the Libre members considered that these three actions to be really priority. Libre should advocate for open access policies and mandates. Libre should advocate for open metrics. And Libre should provide guidance on how to support open metrics and organize the workshops. So within this strategic direction, we have this working group. Today we have the copyright working group who advocates for research-friendly copyright reform. It's a huge work to do, and probably you have heard of that. We have the open access working group, which does advocate and promote open access policies. Perhaps you have seen the five principles for the negotiations of this working group. And we are putting just into place the innovative metrics working group. On the side of the strategic direction, digital skills and services, these are the points that Libre members found more important to develop. Best practices in supporting text and data mining is, of course, a huge theme for everybody. Difficult to manage. Advocate then for research-friendly copyright reform. This is again for the copyright working group. And digital cultural heritage to partner with digital scholars. Of course, many of us, we have huge heritage collection. And so if we digitize them, it can be very interesting for the digital humanity. So within the strategic direction, libraries as a hub for digital skills and services, we do have this existing working group. First, we have the digital humanities, the patrimonio culturale. So this was set up last year. We had before a digitization working group and digital collection working group, but now we focus really on digital humanities. And we aim to define the role of libraries in this specific area, as it is something that many of Libre members prioritize, this new work with digital humanities. It's not the same, perhaps we don't have the same definition as science as in the UK, but digital humanities was considered by many to be quite tricky as something new to work with people that didn't work with these methods in the past. Another working group you may know we have since a long time is leadership. The leadership program was created because it's not easy to find new directors for research libraries in Europe. Because it can be a daunting task to be a director of a research library now, nowadays. Because you have constantly to follow up new technologies and implement innovation management. And so it's Libre's aim to foster a new generation of capable research library leaders throughout Europe through this leadership program. And on the third strategic direction, libraries partnering research infrastructure, these were the priorities set by Libre members. Semantic interoperability, to facilitate the exchange of expertise on enhancing scholarly data and related services. Data stewardship, and advocate for fair data. That's not too surprising, because this is quite a priority for everyone. And this is working group is developing fair RDM policies, advocating for fair data, engaging in development of metadata standards, and developing criteria and guidelines also for the data stewardship and data curation. So far, for the subject that was strongly asked for the leader members. Interestingly, there were some very controversial subjects, and they weren't the smallest subject. This was quite a problem in the discussion afterwards at the board, because at some point you see here with the votes, here put the votes, and why finally it doesn't, they don't show up in the list with very high plus votes. New metrics was quite controversial at some point, because it's difficult. It's not something that it's easy for research libraries to go into. Innovative peer review was very discussed, and you see that in fact it had more negative votes than positives, because people consider it really, really difficult to try to go into peer review, and they would lose their time, they said. There was facilitating the exchange of best practice in licensing negotiations, was very controversial also, with a negative result, because at some point people want to see facts and figures from others, but it's not that easy to share this. Engagement in development of metadata standards has a zero result, in fact, in the voting, because yeah, some go into it, some others say, oh, I don't have the time to go into that. The biggest discussion was about citizen science. They say they have about, well, 80 votes. And in fact, it was in the end a negative vote against citizen science, because so many people said, yes, we have to do citizen science. And even more said, oh no, we don't have the time or the energy to do citizen science. Same with information ethics, explore role of libraries in information ethics and responsible research and innovation was also quite a debate. Lots about, oh, we have to be trustworthy, we have to go into this discussion, and others say, oh God, this is very delicate, no, don't go into it. Shared services, cloud services was also very discussed. This disciplinary partnerships were also very discussed, because, yeah, there are many disciplines, can be uneasy to go into it. And promote the role of libraries to data infrastructure providers and research communities was also quite discussion. So result is still complicated. We have existing groups, we have other groups to come. In the field of digital skills and services, we have new working groups in the text and data mining, shared and cloud services, and linked open data coming up finally. In the field of innovative scholarly communication, we will have new working groups in the citizen science. This, we had this discussion again at the board, and saying, what do we do with the citizen science? Finally got a negative result. we considered that the discussion had been so heavy, it was really a fight about this citizen science, that this is something that shouldn't be ignored, because it's a lively discussion about that, and we want to have this lively discussion. We will try to have a working group into innovative peer review, and also about the information ethics, for the same reason, because the discussion was so intensive, the for and against, that it's worth, we consider it worth to have a discussion in a working group. In the field of the research infrastructure, we will have new working groups about digital skills for staff members and researchers, and the transformation of the service portfolio. But we cannot do all in the same time. So that's why we have a planning here for the years to come. We will have member, I'm interested to go into the working group, so please contact the steering committee and so to be able to participate. Open access working group will stay